What's happening everyone, my name is Alex and welcome back. In today's video we are checking out one of the latest rugged devices from DOOGEE. The one that we have here today, it's called the V31 GT. So of course this phone is shockproof and also waterproof. Shockproof because we have a bit more material on the corners here, so this is kind of like rubberized plastic, I'm gonna say. So if you do drop the phone on a corner like this, nothing should happen to it. And just over the screen here, we have kind of like a lip that will try to protect the screen. Now, keep in mind that the screen is still covered by glass, so if you do drop this the wrong way, let's say that a rock hits the phone and you drop it, well, there is a good chance the screen will still break. So keep that in mind, the screen is still covered by glass. Now, of course, this is also waterproof, so if you want to take this in the shower, if you want to take this to the swimming pool, if you want to swim with it in the sea, of course, you can do all that and nothing will happen to the phone. I actually had it in water the other day and that was a short video recording that I've done underwater with this phone. This phone is powered by the MediaTek Dimensity 1080 that's paired with 12 gigs of RAM and 256 gigs of internal storage. For those of you that like benchmark scores, this is the AnTuTu benchmark score that we get for this device, so you already know that you're not looking at a slow device by any means. So pretty much everything that you're gonna do on this device is done pretty smoothly. So it doesn't matter if you're reading your email, if you're browsing Chrome or watching a video or even playing games, everything does seem to go quite well on this device. So performance-wise, I feel that it has enough power for day-to-day usage for this kind of a device. You've probably noticed by now that this phone is pretty big and pretty thick as well. So this phone actually weighs 390 grams. So yes, whenever you have this phone in your pocket, you will definitely feel it in your pocket because it is a heavy phone. Now, a big part of that is the fact that inside this phone, we have a 10,800 milliamp hour battery. So you're not gonna have to charge this phone every day. You can probably get about 3 days on one charge. Now, what's very nice to see is the fact that the phone actually supports 66 watt fast charging. And we actually have a 66 watt fast charger that comes up in the box. Actually, I think that's a 65 watt fast charger that comes in the box. But basically, this phone charges faster than my Samsung Galaxy S23 and then my iPhone 15 Pro that are about, I don't know, 5 times more expensive than this one. So at least it's nice to see that it has fast charging. Now, we also get dual speakers with this phone, so we have one speaker at the top here. Even though it looks like we have two speakers at the top, it's actually one speaker at the top and one speaker at the bottom here, and the speakers do get quite loud as well. And I guess I can also show you a quick example just so you can hear how those speakers sound like. Taking a closer look at the device, on the right hand side here we have the SIM card slot. The device can take 2 SIM cards or a SIM card and an SD card, and then we have a customizable key. So you can basically have that key open any app you want or any action that you want. And on the other side of the device we have the volume buttons and the power button. The power button is also a fingerprint scanner. As a fingerprint scanner, it does work good. It takes maybe half a second from the time you touch it for the phone to unlock, so overall it works good as a fingerprint scanner. And of course on the front there we also have a front-facing camera, and these are a couple of pictures that I took earlier today with that front-facing camera. The screen on this device is a 6.58 inches IPS panel that has a 1080p resolution, and we also get a refresh rate of 120Hz. Now the colors are nice and vibrant, the viewing angles are really good, but unfortunately the screen doesn't get super bright. So if you're using the phone indoors, no problems whatsoever, but the brightness on the screen is 480 nits. So of course if you do take the phone outside, it is a bit difficult to see the screen if it is a sunny day. So I wish the screen would have been brighter on it, because since this is an outdoor device, it would have been nice to actually see that screen easier. But no, that's the brightness that we get. Moving to the back of the device, well, things get a bit more interesting on the back. So first of all, the device has a thermal imaging system. So you can basically point the phone at any object and you can read the temperature of that object. You can also see the thermal signature. So this could come in handy in many, many situations. These are some example of some measurements that I was doing around the house here. I was basically measuring the temperature of my phone and my computer, just to give you an idea what you could do with that thermal imaging system. Then we have a 50 megapixel main camera, so you'd use this camera to take pictures basically, but then we also have a night camera. So we actually have two infrared LEDs on the back of the phone here, so you can actually take pictures in complete darkness and the phone can basically see in complete darkness with those infrared LEDs. So once again, this could come in handy in many, many situations. As for video, the maximum recording resolution for this device is 4K, but if you're recording in 4K, the video doesn't look that steady. So I recommend that you actually record in 1080p. And this is a quick example of a video that I've done earlier today in 1080p. All right, we have a quick video sample with this new DOOGEE phone that I am trying out. So we are currently recording in 1080p at 30 frames per second. It seems that at this resolution, we also have video stabilization. So I just want to show you how the phone would perform under these conditions. This phone can also record in 4K. However, if you're recording in 4K, that video stabilization doesn't seem to work that well. So this is how recording down the main camera on the back of this device would look like if you're recording in 1080p at 30 frames per second. And as you've seen for yourself, the pictures and videos from this device aren't anything to write home about, but they are on par with what I was actually expecting from this device. I've noticed that pretty much all rugged devices that I got to try don't have the best cameras for pictures and videos. For pictures, they do decent enough, but for videos, the video quality isn't amazing. So it is exactly what I was actually expecting. I wasn't expecting anything better from this device. What's interesting is that thermal imaging system and that night camera that we have on the back there. The phone also has an NFC chip inside it, so if you want to use this phone to make Google payments, you definitely can. And it also supports Wi-Fi 6. So if your router supports Wi-Fi 6, you can get those faster Wi-Fi 6 speeds. So there you have it. This was a super quick look at the DOOGEE V31 GT. All right, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.